Hello, I'm Dr. Mikkel Jarman here with Pediatric Foot and Ankle, and today I'd like to discuss a very specific congenital variation in the foot, polydactyly. Poly meaning many and dactyly meaning digits, or in short, an extra toe. I'd like to also educate you, the parent, regarding what this duplication of an extra toe is, treatment options, and when to treat it. We know polydactyly can develop spontaneously or can be a genetically inherited trait. We do know it is a developmental alteration with the formation of an extra digit on the foot and often on the hands. Depending on the location of the extra digit, it may be classified as preaxial, central, or postaxial. The manifestation of polydactyly may be obvious with the formation of a completely separate digit, or may be less obvious as the digit is merging with another, giving the appearance of a larger than normal toe. The first step in any evaluation is an x-ray. Here in the office, we perform digital x-rays to see exactly what is happening under the skin. X-rays are really helpful to set proper expectations on the type of polydactyly your child has, and also helps to set proper expectation on treatment plans. When treating polydactyly, there are options that are conservative and surgical. Conservative treatment revolves around the difficulty of finding accommodative shoe gear and often the emotional stress that parents feel as their child grows up. Polydactyly is not a painful condition. Again, it is just difficult at times to find accommodative shoe gear that will fit on your child's foot. There is no true consensus on the recommended age of surgical intervention. However, here in my office, as I evaluate children with polydactyly, I recommend that the removal of the toe should be around the ages of 1 to 2 years. It is at this time bone structure has matured and will allow for a more successful cosmetic outcome. Trying to remove the digit sooner runs the risk of not completely removing all of the malformation. There is often a dominant digit, and surgical planning preoperatively needs to be made based off of x-rays and foot structure to ensure the best outcome for your child. Polydactyly can be very nerve-wracking for parents and family. However, this condition is easily treatable and has a great outcome long-term. If your child has polydactyly and you'd like to learn more about what specific treatment options are available for your child, please call our office today and make an appointment. I'm Dr. Mikkel Jarman. Thanks for watching.